Hello friends, welcome to the course on Numerical Linear Algebra. I am Dr. P.N. Agarwal, and on my left side we have Dr. D.N. Pandey.
Hello.
We are both from the Department of Mathematics, IIT Roorkee.
In the present course, we first review some of the basic concepts of matrix algebra, such as linear dependence, independence of vectors, basis and the dimension of subspace of Rn, orthonormal sets in Rn, and eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a matrix. To solve a numerical problem, we need to perform calculation on digital computer. Therefore, we shall discuss the computer representation of number and computer arithmetic. In almost all numerical applications, the input data are often contaminated by errors. Some problems are very sensitive to small perturbation and are called ill-conditioned problems. We discuss the concept of conditioning and the condition number, which indicate the sensitivity of the solution of a problem to small perturbation. The important concept of vector and matrix norms and the convergent matrices, which have an interesting applications in the theory of linear system, will be discussed.
We will define the condition number of a matrix relative to a matrix norm, which plays an important role in the sensitivity analysis and in estimating the nearness to singularity of a given non-singular matrix. The Hegar's algorithm to find an estimate of the condition number will be discussed. We shall discuss the singular value decomposition of a matrix and related concepts which have potential applications in theory of linear systems, image processing, sound processing, control theory, and many more. The problem of finding the least square solutions to a linear system using singular value decomposition will be discussed. These problems have a lot of applications in statistical modeling, image processing, sound processing, and curve fitting, etc. Using the householder matrices, the basic QR factorization of a given matrix will be considered. With the help of QR factorization of a matrix, all the eigenvalues may be obtained. The power method to find the dominant eigenvalue and the corresponding eigenvector for a real diagonalizable matrix will be discussed. This method is very useful in linear control systems theory. Lastly, we discuss the Jacobi method to find all the eigenpairs for a symmetric matrix by using rotation matrices, which are also called Givens matrices.
During the course, assignment will be given to the participant for solving, and submitted assignment will be evaluated at our end. At the end of the course, an examination will be conducted for those who are interested in getting the certificate. We hope that this course will be very useful for UG, PG, students of technical institution, universities, colleges. Thank you.
Thank you.